Over 300 teams start the season with hopes of making it to the NCAA tournament, but only 64 lucky teams received an invitation. These teams start their journey down the road to the Final Four in today's game between the Miami Hurricanes and the Seton Hall Pirates. This is where both teams wanted to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. The Pirates looking at a very capable opponent tonight, Dick. What are their keys to victory, do you think?
If I'm on a bench, Brad, my keys would be simple. First, make good decisions with the rock. Don't turn it over, baby. Second of all, don't let your man beat you to the rebound. Lastly, make your team think defense first. Solid defense will lead to good offense.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. Down inside, he stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
That's a momentum buster.
He's here to fight, baby.
Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Now trying to feed the low block. He makes a nice shot fake. For two. And he missed. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. For the bucket. Perfectly executed. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal him off.
He stays in control until they regroup the offense. From the top of the circle, this team right now just lighting it up from everywhere.
Hey, they're finding each other in rhythm with their passing, Brad. That makes a huge difference in how shooters shoot.
The small forward gets the ball.
Man, he ran his man right into the screen to get off that nice jumper.
Number 15 is emotionally pumped up.
Hey, Brad, I love players that play with emotion. That's why I love the college game.
He gets the rejection. Way off target. He looks at the hoop. The students are all fired up and ready to do whatever's necessary to help their team win.
Aren't they great, Brad? I love it.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Up and in.
Hey, see it all, Brad. They do a lot of recruiting in the New York City and New Jersey area. They usually don't go too far for their players.
This crowd will go crazy if they get a shot to go down here. They go into the low block. There's a bad pass right to the defender. He shoots from outside. Off the rim and no good. The shooting guard takes the pass. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, how about this crowd? They're enjoying this close matchup, and there's nothing better than a close game during tournament time.
Thanks, Aaron. He puts up the J.
That was a brick, man. That was an ugly, ugly look. But inside.
Too much. That's a foul. And Dick, look at this sellout crowd, and they are loving it.
Oh, they're ecstatic, baby. They're ecstatic. Great team play.
Royal steps to the line for the first time. Gets the first. Both.
He converts on that free throw line, and that's major. He's got to pass it or make a play, Brad. Got to think right now. Got to focus defensively.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Hardy is fired up and ready to go.
I love seeing players play with emotion and passion. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that.
The shooting guard gets the pass.
Hey, he should know by now you don't leave your guy open.
Not a very smart move.
Opportunity for two for one.
They'll work it around the arc. He shoots from the top of the key.
And the bricks just keep on coming, baby.
I have to start looking for some easier baskets here, dude.
Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got on the low block. The ball goes out of bounds. Oh, and you talk about a happy group of fans. Listen to this crowd.
Oh, there's all kinds of people standing and cheering and going wacky.
Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. The ball goes out of play. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Turns it over. He keeps his dribble as they reset. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really good. A great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Leans in. Can't get the shot to drop. At the end of the first half, the Hurricanes are ahead by five. Thus far, it's been a tightly contested game. Dick, what's your highlight of the first half?
The three balls are coming, Brad. My highlight has to be this three-pointer. I expect more of that in the second half.
It's time to get back to the court, Dick, and see how their second half plays out. Seton Hall has been giving up the ball like it's worth nothing.
Yeah, Brad, I don't know if I've ever seen a team turn it over like this. They're basically telling their opponents to keep attacking them.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. He shoots from the top of the key.
Poor job on the offensive end. Great job defensively rotating to the basketball. Frustration right there.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. The point guard with the ball. And he scores despite the hack. Nicky's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
For the bucket.
Nice job to create the angle using the glass.
The power forward receives the ball. Dumps it in. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Fakes. He goes with a baby hook. They still don't score. And the ball goes out of play. Nick, look at the number of points off turnover.
I tell you, getting baskets off turnovers is such a great and easy way to score, Brad. You want to maximize these opportunities as much as you can.
Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really doesn't.
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
Oh, and look at the crowd and look at the reaction.
I think the whole fans are going crazy. There's jubilation.
Tries for two. The layup.
That's a breakdown. That'll drive a coach bananas. Hope you don't lose your hair.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Entry pass in the paint for the deuce. Miami are on a bit of a run.
Let's Let's see how long they can keep it on, Brad.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man. Dump it inside.
Lobs it. Goes up for two. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Now the turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, an emotional message from both benches. Let's play our game. That's what got us here. And more importantly, let's believe in one another. Guys?
Looking for a good shot. Outside jumper. Poor decision there to shoot that three.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Adam. Momentary look from three-point land. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Looking to move it around the perimeter. They're working around the perimeter.
That's basic.
Morton is asking the fans for even more encouragement.
I think he feels the importance of this offensive possession.
Look out, he's in the face of the opposition.
I don't know if all of that is necessary, Brad.
He goes to the line for the first time. Gets the first shot. Hits his second. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
Let's get ready to resume the action. Here they go into the break.
They're doing a nice job of getting back on D.
And again, let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
And yet another foul. Foul, and that stops the clock again.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ball game. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. This crowd is unbelievable tonight.
Oh, they're emotional. They're packed. They're jammed. You can't find an empty seat.
Double team now, bad angle.
He goes to the free throw line. Makes the front end of the 1-1. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
Makes the second shot. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
Pull-up jumper from way out. Rims out. He's trying to see if there's an easy one out there. There's a high screen. A does. Watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first, initially, he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebounding position, a good block out. And that's essential in a post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately a block out and get good rebound position.
Dickey still applying great pressure on the dribbler. Here, a five-second call forced by that determined defense. Dick, let's take a look at right now at our backcourt production.
Hey, team success depends on backcourt production, Brad. If you can handle the rock, make good decisions, penetrate, and knock down the open jumper, you give yourself a great opportunity to get to the winner's circle.
With the big shot. Poor shooting behind that arc lately, Dick.
Yeah, they can't seem to find their stroke yet, Brad.
All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on. One team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Miami played exactly the type of game they need to get past their first-round opponent.
Mr. Nesla, if they can execute the way they did today, are you kidding me? Nobody will stop them heading into the second round.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nesler.